Understanding the phrase, driven to despair. Hello, and welcome to our English language learning series. Today, we're going to explore a fascinating English expression, driven to despair. This phrase is rich in meaning and is used in various contexts. Whether you're a beginner or an advanced learner, understanding such expressions can greatly enhance your English proficiency. So, let's dive in and unravel the layers of meaning behind driven to despair. Driven to despair is an idiomatic expression used to describe a situation where someone is pushed into a state of extreme sadness or hopelessness. The word driven in this context means to be compelled or forced into a particular state, and despair refers to the loss of hope or a feeling of utter hopelessness. It's often used to describe situations where external circumstances or actions of others led a person to this state. Understanding how to use driven to despair in sentences can clarify its meaning. Here are a few examples. 1. After losing his job and struggling to find a new one, John was driven to despair. 2. The constant criticism from her peers eventually drove Maria to despair. 3. In many classic novels, characters are often driven to despair by tragic events. These examples show that the phrase is often used in serious contexts and conveys a strong emotional state. Knowing synonyms and variations of the phrase can help you understand it better and use it more effectively. Some synonyms include plunged into despair, pushed to the brink, lost all hope. Each of these expressions carries a similar meaning but may be used slightly differently depending on the context. When using driven to despair, be careful not to confuse it with phrases that have different meanings. For example, driving in despair implies actively driving while feeling despair, which is quite different. Also, avoid using it in a light-hearted or casual context, as the phrase carries a weighty, serious tone. I hope this video has helped you understand the phrase driven to despair and how to use it effectively in English. Remember, learning such expressions not only improves your language skills but also helps you connect more deeply with the culture and emotions conveyed in the language. Keep practicing, and soon you'll be using English phrases like a native speaker. Thanks for watching, and see you in our next video.